But you are engaged to me.
That makes no matter, Pierrot. If you love me, should ye not be glad that I am to be made a madam?
No, I would as soon see you hanged as see you another's.
Come, come, Pierrot, do not fret yourself. If I am a madam, I shall make you gain something. You shall serve us with butter and cheese.
Sounds. I shall never serve you with anything, even if you would pay me twice as much. Do not listen thus to what he says. This fish had known this just now. I should not have taken him out of the water at all. I would have given him a good rap upon the head with my oar.
What is that you say?
Dread it, I fear no man.
Let me only get hold of you.
I do not care, nor I.
We shall try that.
Oh, I have seen many a man as good as you.
What?
Oh, sir, let the poor wretch alone. It is a pity to bait him. Harkee, my poor lad, move off, and do not talk to him.
I will talk to him.
Ha! I shall teach you.
Plague take the booby.
That is a reward for your charity.
Sams, I shall go and tell her aunt of all her goings-on.
At last, I am going to be the happiest of men, and I will not change my happiness for all the world could give me. And what pleasures shall we have when you are my wife? And what?
So.
Sir, what are you doing there with Charlotte? Are you courting her too?
No. On the contrary, she told me she wished to be my wife, and I told her I was engaged to you.
What is that Mathurine wants with you?
She is jealous of my speaking to you, and would like me to marry her. But I tell her it is you whom I wish to have.
What, Charlotte?
All you can say to her will be of no use. She took this into her head.
What then, Mathurine?
It is in vain to talk to her. You will not get this whim out of her head.
Would you?
There is no possibility of making her listen to reason.
I should like.
She is as obstinate as the devil.
Really?
Do not say anything to her. She's a fool.
I think.
Let her alone. She is silly.
No, no. I must speak to her.
I will hear some of her reasons.
What?
I will lay you a wager that she tells you that I promised to marry her.
I
will bet you anything that she will maintain that I have given her my word to make her my wife.
Hark you, Charlotte. It is not right to meddle with other folks' bargains.
It is not polite to be jealous because the gentleman speaks to me.
The gentleman saw me first.
If he saw you first, he saw me second and has promised to marry me.
Well, did I not tell you so?
Your humble servant, it was me and not you whom he promised to marry.
Did I not guess right?
You may tell that to others if you please, but not to me. It was me he promised to marry, I tell you.
You make fun of folks. Once more, it was me he promised to marry.
There he is. He can tell you whether I am right.
There he is. He can give me the lie if I do not speak the truth.
Did you promise to marry her?
You're joking.
Is it true, sir, that you have given your word to be her husband?
Could you entertain such a thought?
You see, she affirms it.
Let her alone.
You are witness how positive she is.
Let her say what she likes.
No, we must know the truth.
We must have it decided.
Yes, Mathurine, I will have the gentleman show you your mistake.
Yes, Charlotte, I will have the gentleman make you look foolish.
Decide the quarrel, sir, if you please.
Satisfy us, sir.
You shall see.
And you shall see, too.
Speak!
Speak!
What would you have me say? You both maintain that I have promised to marry you. Does not each of you know the whole business without any necessity for me giving any more explanations? Why should you oblige me to repeat what I have said? Has not the person to whom I really gave the promise sufficient reasons within herself to laugh at what the other says? And ought she to trouble herself, provided I keep my promise? All the speeches do not forward affairs. We must act and not talk. Facts prove more than words. Therefore, that is the only way in which I shall satisfy you. And when I marry, you shall see which of you two has my heart. Let her believe that she will. Let her flatter herself in her own imagination. I adore you. I am entirely yours. All faces are ugly in comparison with yours. When a man has once seen you, he cannot bear to look at others. I have some trifling message to deliver. I shall be back again in a quarter of an hour.
I am the one he loves, however.
He will marry me.
Ah, poor girls. I pity your innocence. I cannot bear to see you run thus to your destruction. Believe me both, do not be imposed upon by the stories he tells you, but stay in your village.
I should fain know why Scannerel does not follow me.
My master is a knave. He only wishes to make fools of you. He has made fools of a good many others. He marries the old sex, and it is false. And whoever tells you this, you may tell him he lies. My master does not marry the old sex. He is no knave. He does not intend to deceive you, nor has he ever made a fool of anyone. Oh, stay. Here he is. Ask him yourself.
Yes?
Sir, as the world is full of backbiters, I was beforehand with them. And I was telling these girls that if anybody should say anything wrong of you, they ought not to believe him, and be sure to tell him that he lied.
Scannerel!
Yes, my master is an honourable man. I'll warrant him such.
Ahem.
They are impertinent rascals.
Sir, I came to tell you that it is not quite safe for you to be here.
How so?
12 men on horseback are in search of you. They will be here in a moment. I do not know how they have followed you, but I have learned these tidings from a countryman of whom they inquired, and to whom they described you. As there is no time to lose, the sooner you leave here, the better.
Urgent business obliges me to leave this place, but I entreat you to remember the promise which I made you. Depend upon it, you shall hear from me before tomorrow evening. As we are unequally matched, we must make use of a stratagem and cleverly escape from the misfortune that pursues me. Scannerel, you shall put on my clothes, and I...
Sir, you are joking. To expose me to be killed in your clothes, and...
Make haste. I do you too much honor. Happy is the servant who has the glory of dying for his master.
Thank you for such an honor. As it is a case of death, grant me a favor, O heaven, not to be taken for another.